Hello everyone, and this is the first of a series of presentations concerning English grammar rules from a language school located in central Evia. My name is Angelos Vourdakis, and I've been teaching English in this area for over 20 years. So this is one of about 20 grammar rules this school year concerning the B senior class. This is grammar rule number 5. It has to do, as you can see, with the uses of the past continuous tense. The uses of the past continuous tense are 3 mainly. The first one says that an action in progress at a specific time in the past. For example, the teacher was explaining inquiries yesterday at 6 p.m. We can see that the verb was explaining is in the past continuous tense. And the example refers to a specific time in the past. The time in the past was yesterday, and specifically 6 p.m. yesterday. The second use of the past continuous tense is an action of long duration interrupted by a sudden one. For example, the kids were running when one of them was hit by a car. As we can see, the action of long duration is were running. It's in the past continuous tense. And the other shorter action which interrupted it is was hit, and it's in the past simple tense. So, the sudden one is in the past simple tense, and it interrupted the other one with the longer duration. Number 3, the third and last use of the past continuous tense, 2 actions with duration progressing at the same time in the past. In other words, in this example, both verbs are in the past continuous tense, and they were in progress at the same time. Example, while the girl was eating, her mother was cooking. We can see clearly that was eating and was cooking are both in the past continuous tense, and they are both actions happening at the same time in the past. Finally, the above tense is used in sentences with the key time words while and as. In other words, if in a sentence you see either the word while or the time word as, the tense you must use is the past continuous tense of the verb. This and every grammar rule during the school year should be learned by the students for homework right after my explanation. They can ask relative questions, and some Greek, but a little, can be used for some points of each rule. For any inquiries concerning this grammar rule, you can do so right below. Finally, if you are in need of other English grammar rules, please do not hesitate to text us your requests. Thank you very much for watching.